feel so good, it's true. So glad that I have you. You love me so. Now all is bright. I'll always thank you for the glow, and thank you for the joy. Thank you for the love you give.
May I request everyone to please stand for the singing of the national anthem to be followed by the Binabangsa school song.
We recognize that you are the source of wisdom and strength. Thank you for your guidance throughout the year, especially during our home-based learning. We're so happy to finally graduate from preschool. Thank you for parents who love us so much. Thank you for school and teachers who molded us to be lifelong learners. We'll give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
To our principal, Ms. Sweeney, our administrators, preschool teachers, beloved parents, my fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Binabang Sub Preschool Big Virtual Graduation Ceremony. On behalf of my friends, I would like to thank all of you for being part of our preschool years. Let me quote to you some lines from the poem entitled All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten by Robert Fulcher. Most of what I really need to know about how to live and what to do and how to be, I learned in kindergarten. These are the things I learned. Share everything, play fair, don't hit people, put things back where you found them, clean up your own mess, don't take things that aren't yours. Say you're sorry when you hurt somebody, when you go out into the world, watch out for traffic, hold hands, and stick together. Be aware of water. Indeed, we have learned all these things with your guidance, your loving and dedicated parents and teachers. We are so thankful of what you have done for us. Today, may we be blessed and God be glorified to this 2020 big virtual graduation ceremony. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning to all parents, teachers, and my dearest K2 graduates. 2020 is a tough year. We had a lot of things going through ever since we entered this new year. We had flood just on day one of 2020. Then within the same month, we had weeks of super traffic jam around our school's neighborhood. Remember when you had to go down from your vehicles and walk to school because of the jam? It was indeed a true test to our patience. Then, to put a cherry on top, we had this COVID-19 outbreak, forcing us to stay at home for months with uncertainties. Dear my K2 graduates, it is very easy to stay upset and grumpy when things don't go as planned, or be discouraged when you don't get what you want. But let me tell you something, God made us as fighters, not quitters. Look around you and see how coronavirus has taken over our once normal lives. Do you see the world stop? People stay grumpy all the time, they stop doing anything, and just let the virus rule? No, in fact, people are working even harder right now. They're working hand in hand to fight this virus. Doctors and nurses are working very hard to find the vaccine to help people who are sick. Your teachers are working hard teaching from home, preparing the materials, just to make sure that you continue your study at home. Everyone try their best to cope with this change in every way they can. Your parents, they might have to work from home while helping you with your study and taking care of you. Right now, I want you to look at your parents, give them a big hug, and tell them, "Thank you, Mommy and Daddy, for helping me, for everything you've done. I love you." How about you? You yourself had to cope with this change, right? You have to study at home. I know it was not easy, but you did it. You see, the world did not stop. We don't give up. It strives. What do we learn from this? I want you to remember three messages that Ms. June is going to give you today as you move up to primary. number one, we cannot stop changes from happening. But what we can do is to learn to adapt and to not give up. Remember the first time when you have to study from home, when you cannot go to school, there are a lot of changes happening at that time. You cannot meet your friends, you cannot study in the classroom. Instead, you can just look at the screen and do study from Zoom meetings. It was not easy, right? But see, you did not give up. And where you are right now, you have completed your preschool study. You will probably face the same difficulties as you go to primary one. It is not going to be easy at first, but do not give up. Learn to adapt to the change. Remember, practice makes perfect. Number two, do the best according to the portion, to your portion, according to what you can do. Doctors and nurses do their best according to their portion. What can they do? They help sick people. Your teachers do their best according to their portion. What is it? It's to prepare things to teach you even from their home. How about your portion? As a student, your portion is to, yes, study hard. As a son and daughter of your parents, what is your portion? What can you do? It's to listen and obey. The third one, last but not least. Now we know that there are things that are beyond our control. Things that we cannot stop from happening. What do? We walk day by day with God. You need to remember that everything, things in this world, including you and me, belongs to God. And that He has prepared the best for us. So we can continue to put our hope in Him. Remember the song that we learned during chapel time? I heard from your teachers that this is one of your favorite songs. You like to sing it in your class. You take my hand, you never walk away, as you change my heart, day by day. So please remember these three messages that I give you today. First thing, learn to adapt to change, do not give up. Number two, do your best according to your portion. Number three, walk day by day with God. He will never leave you. My dear K2s, I really wish right now I could hug you one by one and shake your hand and congratulate you. But unfortunately, we cannot do so right now. So I'll keep it until the time I can see you again and do so. Right now, I think this will have to do, my message will have to do. Your teachers and I will always be praying for you. I love you, and I will miss you all. Thank you, God bless you.
Parents, teachers, ladies and gentlemen, presenting to you the graduates of Binabangsa School, Peak Preschool of the academic year 2020. Albert Jensen Dajaya, most diligent. Aldrich Shan Austria, most improved in computer. Audrey Tay Yu Huwei, most polite. Aurora Gracia, star reader. Bella Camila, creative writer. Bianca Grace Yunanto, Miss Sunshine. Catalina Celia Justicio, most improved in numeracy. Chloe Wong, most polite. Danube Thier Vijaya, word star. Devon Sun, enthusiastic participant. Federico Franklin, Super Citizen. Gerard Cooper Tan, Best in Penmanship. Jaden Chinga, Most Improved in Chinese. Jaden Lewis Wijaya, Creative Storyteller. Jaden Uttama Putra, Young Scientist. Jesslyn Peck, Awesome Artist. Joe Jaden Lee, Most Improved in Phonics. Jolie Kimberly Chen Lee, Most Neat. Caldner Katsidi, Enthusiastic Participant. Carlos Roberto Zuo, Most Improved in Chinese. Karen Michela Zuo, Inquisitive Learner. Kevin, Young Leader.
Kimi Vania Thanos, Eager Learner. Leonardo Havardi, Young Athlete. Leon Chris Wood Wu, Mr. Sunshine. Lee Lin Chen, Super Citizen. Lee Lin Sen, Most Persevering. Madeline Kinsey Wardheim, Most Talented. Marvelous Michael Ginardo, Most Improved in Computer. Megan Angeline, Most Improved in Language. Michael Maxwell Wu, Young Leader. Michelle Su, Most Improved in Bahasa Indonesia. Nicole Chen Nike, Most Diligent. Nixon Wellington Sudarmo, Most Improved in Bahasa Indonesia. Sean Wesley Leonardo, Young Athlete. Stella Ko, Miss Sunshine. Sun Jia Jun, Most Responsible. Tila Wu, Most Helpful. Fernando Jap, Star Reader. Wang Xinyi, Awesome Artist. Warren James Tanyos, Number Smart. Xavier Bradford Muliono, Most Persevering. Zisela Zanta Brielle, Most Improved in Reading. Congratulations, students! We are proud of you. Parents, teachers, ladies and gentlemen, let us give a round of applause to our graduates.
Never stop learning, never stop growing, never stop seeking the brightest star, never stop moving from where you are,
never stop trying, never stop reaching, never stop doing what you can do, never stop growing your whole life through.
What we learn is up to us. What we see, we find. Never doubt what you have inside. All you need is
you for your endless patience and unending care. You taught me how to be a good student to help me reach my goals. All the things I learned from you will stay with me until I'm old. Without a doubt, you are the best parent one could have. I want to thank you for always being there for me. I love you.
Teachers, for all your patience day to day, for every tear you wipe away, and the little hands you gently hold, and the sharp minds you have yet to mold, and the consoling tender heart, and the wisdom you impart, for the silly things and quiet times, and the peaceful nighttime chimes. We thank you for the teachers of what you do.
Happy to let you know, you make me glow. I feel so good, it's true. So glad that I have you. You love me so. Now all is bright. I'll always thank you for the glow, and thank you for the joy. Thank you for the love you give to me. I'm glowing, glowing in time with your love shining through. Thank you for everything you do. I'm glowing inside because of you. Remember my growing years, they're filled with joy because you're there for me. You kiss my fears away, wipe those tears. You gave me strength each day. I thank you for the glow, and thank you for the joy. Thank you for the love you give to me. I'm glowing, glowing inside.
Hardships. we went through. This pandemic made us realize that we can overcome trials when we hold hands and work together. To our school principal, Ms. Rini, and teachers, thank you for making a way for us to finish this academic year. Thank you for patience and guidance during Zoom classes. To our parents, we thank you for your unconditional love, sacrifices, and guidance. Thank you for giving us a wonderful home to stay and to study, especially during home-based learning. Thank you for giving us the best in life. Most of all, we thank you, God, for your favor and blessings. Thank you for your great love for all of us. May you keep us safe always. All glory to you alone.
Dear God, thank you for our parents, teachers, and administrators. We thank you for their love and support to us graduates. We pray that you bless them as they continue to nurture and guide us. I also pray for all of us graduates. Please continue to give us the wisdom and help us to always give our best in our studies. May we always find joy in learning. God, we thank you for all the things that we have learned in preschool. Thank you for everything, especially in this memorable time of our life. All glory belongs to you. In Jesus' name I pray, Amen.
Thank you, dear parents and graduates. Congratulations once again, and God bless you all.
With the power vested in me as a school principal, with great honor and pride, I now confirm you graduates of the academic year 2019-2020. May I request the parents to please move the tassel to the left.
Thank you.
Congratulations, our dear graduates. May God continue to bless you all with wisdom as you move up to primary years.